Have you ever experienced that you were using your laptop on a coffee shop or outside your home and then you're doing some project and then all of a sudden, malapit na madrain yung laptop mo, eh kailangan mong tapusin yung project na yun. What we're gonna vlog today is how to lessen the battery drain of your laptop. So I'm gonna teach you a step-by-step process. This is not actually for advanced. Actually, kahit yung mga bago palang gumagamit ng laptop, I will gonna walk you through on how to, you know, configure the settings on your laptop para malessen yung drain. That's why I have here my personal laptop, which is an Acer Predator. So by the way, after this video, we'll be giving 5 Acer Predator loot bags. So, makita niyo dyan sa videos kung ano yung makakasama inside the loot bags. Please do like and subscribe to our page kasi kung sino man nung gumagawa nun, ang may chance na manalo ng Predator loot bag na ito. Now, let's proceed on how to save your battery life. Number one, use a power saver mode. So, how do you do that? In Windows 11, on the bottom right screen, where you can see the time and the date, there's actually a battery icon there. Just click on it, and then there's a button here that you can click on a battery saver. Now, right now, this is enabled on battery saver. The brightness was reduced. We're gonna talk about the brightness too. And then, if you're using a Windows 10 laptop, you just click on the battery icon. It's also on the bottom right corner. And you're gonna see a graph there. If you want it on best battery life or in best performance, you just need to drag it on the best battery life. Number two, only open limited programs. Bakit limited? Because the more programs that you open, mas maraming memory ang makakoconsume. Pag mas maraming memory ang kukonsume, it will require more power. If it requires more power, it will consume more battery. For example, I'm using a Google Chrome here. If I open more tabs, mas malaki ang memory na makukonsume nito. Not to mention, yung mga ibang applications pa katulad ng mga AutoCAD or yung mga 3D engineering softwares. Because those applications, katulad ng AutoCAD, it requires a high specification of laptop. Kaya nga, pag bumibili tayo ng laptop for AutoCAD, diba mostly ang binibili natin is mga i5 or above na may video card. It's also same na pag hindi nakasaksak yung laptop nyo, tapos nag-open kayo ng mga AutoCAD or yung mga AAA games, magkoconsume talaga yan ng battery. Kaya nga, as much as possible, dapat i-open lang natin yung application na kailangan natin. And not to mention, kahit sa pag-i-stream natin ng mga videos or like sa YouTube, if you watch a YouTube on a 4K quality, mas mabilis mag-drain ng battery life. Yan. That is why, if you're watching a YouTube nang hindi nakasaksak yung charger, it is better na mas mababa yung quality ng pinapanood mo. Number three, as much as possible, disable some applications. Every time that you open your laptop, minsan nakala natin walang nag-run na program dyan. Technically, maraming nag-o-open sa background ng laptop mo. Here on my laptop itself, mayroon naka-open dito na Viber, may naka-open dito na mga game applications, may MSI Afterburner pa dito and OBS. So, the more applications running on the background, mas mabilis nagko-consume yung battery nyo. Don't you know that this could save up to 50% of your battery life? Now, if I'm gonna open a task manager, currently ang naka-open lang sa akin dito is task manager, OBS, and Google Chrome. Now, dito sa baba, makikita nyo may background process na 130. So, meaning to say, there is 130 application at the back of this laptop. As much as possible, kung pwede nating i-disable yan to save battery, it would be better. Kasi the more na dinidisable mo yan, mas magiging longer yung battery life ng laptop. Now, hindi lahat to pwede mong i-disable because some of these are Windows. Ang pinaka-safe para ma-disable yung mga applications dito sa laptop is go here at the bottom right corner of your screen and click this arrow button. You can just simply here, for example, the Viber, I want to disable it, just click on exit. This Discord, I want to exit it, just click on Discord. The Steam, exit. Awesome. And then the MSI, I'm just gonna close that out. The Epic Games, sign out din natin yan. Someone might ask, do I need to put it on airplane mode para makasave ng battery life? Actually, you don't need to put it on airplane mode because we've actually done a test na the airplane mode and the non-airplane mode, parehas lang yung battery duration nila. However, as much as possible, i-disable nyo yung Bluetooth pag hindi nyo naman ginagamit. Normally, on Windows 11, naka-off naman yung Bluetooth. Now, how to know if your Bluetooth is on or it's off? On the bottom right corner again, dito sa may battery icons, and then the Wi-Fi, dito, you will see a Bluetooth button here. Ngayon, if it is not highlight in blue, meaning it's off. If it is in blue, it means it's on. For the Wi-Fi, you don't need to turn off your Wi-Fi. Because, kaya nga may built-in ka na Wi-Fi card dito sa laptop natin eh. The only time that the Wi-Fi will consume battery, if you're gonna do some streaming, if you'll do some downloading. Kung hindi naman nakakonek yung mga Wi-Fi mo sa any routers or any modem, it will not consume any battery. And in case naman nakakonek siya sa internet doing some downloads, hindi naman ganun kalakas ang konsumo niya. Ang pinakamalakas pa rin magkonsumo, yung mga background apps. Yung mga unnecessary background apps. Number 4, unplug unused peripherals. Ano tong mga peripherals na to? Just like here, nakakonek yung mobile phone ko sa laptop. Currently, hindi naka-charge yung laptop ko. Normally, if we're gonna go to a coffee shop or whatsoever, sometimes kasi medyo malolobat na yung cellphone natin, kaya ginagawa natin, kumukuha tayo ng saksakan at sinasaksak sa laptop natin. Unfortunately, pag ginagawa natin yon, yes, nag-charge yung mobile phone natin, pero dinedrain natin yung battery ng laptop natin para mapasa sa mobile phone. It's not just in mobile phones. Sometimes we also connect USB keyboards. And sometimes meron pang nabibili na USB na fan eh. Even in laptop coolers, di ba? Pag sinaksak mo yung laptop cooler sa laptop mo, it will produce fan and yung ibang mga may mga ilaw pa eh. Of course, the more fans na kabit dyan, mas magkoconsume siya ng battery. Kaya nga mostly yung mga gumagamit ng mga laptop coolers, nakasaksak din yung laptop nila para even. There are some customers kinakabit rim light, di ba? Kasi they're doing it for vlogging purposes. Including din dito, yung volume ng speaker natin. The louder the speaker, mas malakas ang konsumo ng battery. Kaya nga as much as possible, dapat yung speaker natin is sakto lang sa ano natin. Or, kung kaya nyo magkabit ng headset, actually that will save you more battery compared using your sound speaker sa laptop. Isama na natin dyan yung mga speakers na nakakabit sa USB, even yung mga external hard disk na kinakabit natin sa USB. Kasi pag kinabit mo yung external hard disk, may umiikot dun sa loob na external hard disk. Of course, that needs power and kinukuha rin niya sa laptop. Not to mention din yung mga Bluetooth speakers na yan. If you connect a Bluetooth speaker, any Bluetooth device on your laptop, it also consumes battery. It's fine kung nakasaksak yung laptop ng charger nyo. Pero pag hindi, it is much better na hugutin yung mga to as much as possible para humaba yung battery life ng laptop natin. Number 5, reduce the monitor brightness. Actually, isa to sa malalaking factors na makakapag-save ng battery life ng laptop mo. Normally, if you're gonna put it on power saver mode or in battery saver, your laptop automatically reduce the brightness. Pero you could actually still customize it. On this scenario, my laptop just put it on 75% or whatsoever. Now, I reduce it to 50% para mas mag-prolong yung battery life. And not to mention, kasama rin dito yung screen resolution ng laptop nyo. Mas malakas mag-consume ng battery ang 4K resolution compared to a Full HD. Ganun din, mas malakas mag-consume ang battery ng Full HD sa HD resolution. But that is just only a small factor. Some research happened that reducing the resolution of the laptop could only save you up to 10% of battery life. So hindi naman siya ganun ka-ideal, pero but if you're in the brink na talagang kailangan mo talaga ng battery or tipirin yung battery mo, the resolution of the laptop will do. Not to mention, kasama rin dyan yung hertz ng laptop natin. Normally, ang mga gaming laptop, medyo matataas ang mga hertz niyan. Minsan, nasa 165, 144. The standard is 60 hertz. Like me, my laptop is running on 144 hertz. Pero just for the sake, I'll try to reduce this on 60 hertz para doon sa mga ibang viewers natin para alam nila paano i-reduce yung hertz. So, I'll teach you guys how to reduce the resolution and reduce the hertz of a Windows 11 laptop. Just click on the start button here and type the word display. Or on the fastest way to do it is just right click and then there's the properties, you're gonna see it. On the display, you'll see here the display resolution at the middle. Currently, this is in Full HD 1920x1080. Now, if you're in the brink that you really need to save battery life, you can just reduce this to 1366x768 and then kung matcha-charge nyo ulit yung laptop nyo, pwede nyo naman ulit ibalik yung normal resolution niya. And the other thing that could save your battery life is reducing the hertz of this laptop. Normally, ang mga gaming laptop, mas mataas sa 60 hertz. Like here, it's currently 144 hertz. I can reduce it to 60 hertz. Now, reducing this 60 Hz is actually medyo hindi naman manonotice if you're just gonna do some office work. Not unless you're playing games. However, dito sa Hertz, ito yung pwede mong laruin because this Hertz could save you up to 10% of your battery life din. Lastly, isa pa sa makakasave ng battery life nyo is the backlit keyboard of your laptop. Disabling the backlit keyboard of your laptop could save up to 30% of your battery life. So, late ko na lang din na-notice yun. Pero kasi, like gaming laptop, sometimes you could customize the backlit keyboard, you could change it to green, to red, to blue, to any color of it. But doing that, it actually consumes battery. Now, kung nasa labas ka, hindi mo naman na kailangan i-flex yung ilaw ng laptop mo, you just turn it off, and it will save you more battery. And lastly, number 6, keep it cool. What do we mean cool? Normally kasi ang laptop, pag medyo mainit ang laptop, mas mabilis siyang nagde-drain ng battery. You would notice that if you're opening a heavy software or heavy application, it will consume memory, it will consume more processor. Now, every time that your processor is burning or even your video card is burning, umiinit yan. Kaya nga tinawag na burning, di ba? Ngayon, pag umiinit sila, mas mabilis nagko-consume yung battery. Kaya nga, as much as possible, if you're gonna use a laptop, ensure na medyo okay yung temperature ng room, it's cool, or medyo okay ang airflow. Kasi pag mainit yung lugar, it also contributes na mabilis mag-drain yung laptop. Not to mention, if mainit yung laptop, technically, mag-e-enable ang fan yan. The hotter the laptop, mas malakas yung fan. Now, pag mas malakas yung fan, mas malakas ang pag-de-drain ng battery. I hope these battery tips ay makatulong sa inyo. And then, if you like the video, please do like the video and then subscribe to our page. And malay nyo, kayo yung manalo ng mga giveaways namin. So, just to wrap it up, here are the tips para hindi agad madrain yung battery ng laptop nyo. Number 1, make it on power saver. Number 2, reduce the brightness of your laptop. Or number 3, turn off the backlit keyboard of your laptop. And number 4, as much as possible, disable some background applications. And number 5, avoid warm area. And then, on our next coming video, we're also gonna teach you how to prolong your battery life. Wherein, normally kasi ang mga laptop battery life, minsan mga 2 to 3 years lang eh. After that, mabilis na ma-deplete or mabilis ma-drain yung laptop. So, we're gonna teach you paano to extend it to 5 to 6 years, paano humahaba yung cycle count ng battery life. And then, we're also gonna teach you how to read a battery report. So, after this video, we'll be announcing the winners of the 5 Predator loot bags. And then again, this is Dustin from Laptop Factory. Have a good day. Bye-bye. Probably on our next video, we're gonna teach you how to prolong the battery life. Just to sum it up, here are the tips para hindi maubos agad. Hindi maubos agad yung battery niyo. So, just to sum it up, paano, ang hirap no, English mo, tapos sigla may tatagalog ako, di ba?